Does it work? We good? We got green lights here. Start. Looks like it started recording as well. Huh. This might actually be working. Okay, alright. Here we go. Oh, need my chat. Let's keep the chat going. See what y'all saying. Pizza! What's up, pizza? Alright, so did I post that? Oh yeah, cool. Alright. Boogie, what's up? Gasp, Windows. How's it going, guys? Man, this is going to be a pretty experimental day here. What's up, Pedro? Because I don't know if this is going to work or not. I'm trying to do some streaming here on Windows today and see if I can improve the performance of the Windows build of Songbringer. Oh, by the way, for the record, this is Songbringer for the YouTube video. There's a new member of Scottish Pizza Games. Who's that? And is he Scottish? Does he like pizza? How do I change that one option? Visual C++ change number of CPUs. I got it, turns out last time I streamed on Windows, it would crash the stream every time I compiled. Because maximum number of parallel builds was crazy. So, tools, options. Alright. Irish Pizza Games? What? We'll be working on separate games under the same name. Nice, and of course he's Scottish. Right on, man. Okay, tools, options. Projects and solutions, build and run. Build and run. Okay, let's do two maximum number of parallel project builds at once for now. And let me change something, like anything, just recompile main.cpp. We'll run this, and let's see if OBS crashes. OBS, stay alive, buddy, stay alive, OBS, you got it. It looks like it's gonna work. Ooh, there's a little orange flash, though. So I'm definitely gonna need some help today, because I have no idea how to profile in Visual Studio. So if anybody knows how to do that. All right, look at this. Sweet, we even got this the same saves as before. Wizard, a couple of things I found on the alpha when you hit certain enemies and they kind of go flying, they can go through solid objects. Yeah. Jib is designed that way right now to go flying through walls and enemies. I'll definitely take a look at that. I guess that worked. What was I gonna do just now, though? I guess I just wanna pr- oh, I wanna go. To the saves. This should be my local file, projects, Windows, saves. Yeah. I should have settings Mac, and I should also have settings Windows now. No love. Oh, that's because. Azenris, what's up? Yeah. If it starts to make the bing noise and left click on the game. Right. You just reselected it. Like you alt tabbed out, alt tabbed back in. What's up, Azenris? Stayed off, what's up? Hey, so you guys, I'm really needed. I need some guidance here on Visual Studio Windows. How do I profile? Like I would love. When I run the game on in debug mode, it runs really, really slow, but that's not the main issue. The main issue is when I run in release mode, some people have reported some periodic like slowdowns. Like every second or every 5 seconds or every 10 seconds the game slows down. So I want to do some profiling today, and I have no idea how to profile in Visual Studio. Maybe it's here in test. I don't know. Okay. I think. It randomly does it? Oh, with the like deselecting somehow? I'm thinking there's something on your system that's somehow taken away. Oh, debug, start diagnostic without debug? Ah, okay. All right, CPU usage, GPU usage, memory usage, performance wizard. Let's start all three of these. I can't do those. Can't do that. Start with just CPU usage, I guess. Performance wizard sounds like it. Really? Yeah, but this one just says .NET memory. Well, yeah, it's the wizard, man. We gotta try the wizard first. What method of profiling would you like to use? CPU sampling. Instrumentation. Oh, this is just a wizard that shows me the same options again. It's Born a Snipe. You streamed some Songbringer? Whoa, nice, man. The old version? Ooh, this is recommended. The wizard's recommending this. The wizard's not letting me click on this because it's put in too big of a window. Wizard, you're not very smart. Wizard. This is why I don't use Windows. Shit like this. Oh. God damn. Starting the profile. Okay, so it's definitely profiling because it's running slower. Is the stream still running? Abort! Yeah, it's running way slower now, that's for sure, so it must be doing something profiling-wise. That's kind of weird too. See that when it scrolls, it does a whole bunch of VSync glitching. Maybe it's not VSynced on Windows. That's ugly. Okay, let's see. I wonder if that's enough time to check out the wizard's results here. Oh, my debug keys don't work. It's always like that for you? Damn, so this is exactly why I want to profile today and figure out why the hell it runs slower on Windows or what's going on. So, all right, let's exit the game. Pizza's an amazing seed. Nice. What's up, Arcane? Yeah, sorry, the sound's different because I'm on Windows. So, Windows, I haven't installed Game Show on Windows. Oh, here we go. We've got a sampling profiling report. Okay, I don't think I need to look at this whole this diagnostic tools thing. Can you put this in the same? Oh, what? Oh, yeah. I got these three windows down there now. Dock. Don't unpin. There. Wait, did that. What did that do? It disappeared. I'm so lost. When you play it, right, yeah, so it does that for you all the time. Bonus knife, you like the old floppy? Oh, thanks. Thanks, Boogie. Oh my god, I was like, where did it go? Okay, so there's that window. Went all the way to the bottom left. Thank you. I feel much less lost now. Okay, here's the sampling profiling report. I can select some time. It looks like it didn't use very much CPU. This is like similar to how it does on Mac. It's like, you know, it's sitting there at 20% or so of the CPU. Call tree. Let's look at the call tree. Here's another thing I hate about Windows. I wish it would just, if I'd stretched a freaking tab, I wish it would automatically stretch the other ones like Mac does. Sorry, don't mean to gripe, but Windows makes me gripey. It's all your fault, Windows. You thought it was deliberately slow? It's fine when it's playing, though? What do you mean? Or, wait, what? I thought you said it was always like that for you. Weird because we have these are inclusive samples, exclusive sample. This is where it's updating the tick. See, I'm kind of confused because like it says 4,000 here and then it's only got 500 there. I don't know where the hell the other 3,200 went. Nice. You redid your mountain range and your suite and your website. You feel gravy on Mac? Yeah. Good. I'm glad. I'm glad we have that reciprocal, right? At least I'm not the only one being gripey about something. Okay. Let's dive into this tick update. This is where it runs all the systems of the game. So yeah, render system. This is very similar to how the game runs on Mac. The render system takes up most of the stuff. Oh, this is the tick. Move system, controllers. Well, this is kind of good to know, all this stuff, but it's still not it's not revealing what would be causing a periodic slowdown. Like, some people have reported the game periodically just slows down. Loading up, it's slow, but playing, it's fine. Every time I play IR. Huh. I wish I'd. How would I go and find a periodic slowdown with Visual Studio? It looks like there's not really any spikes. That could be because my computer's all right. Maybe it slows down on other people's computers that are slower. Maybe they're using a PC from the 90s. Exactly. We both thought the same thing there. Yeah, I guess. Can you do this, Azrael? Do you know if you can do this in debug mode? Because I'd love to know what slows the game down in debug mode. Because it's really slow in debug mode. I think it's probably because I think Visual Studio adds hooks and stuff to even every little memory allocation. And so when the game goes and it creates the entire world, there's a hell of a lot of things it's allocating and adding to maps and adding to vectors and things like that. And I think Visual Studio even has checks for vectors. Like, you add to a vector, it makes sure you're not going beyond its bounds or something. Not enough RAM, maybe. Welcome, newest guest. What up, everybody? Oh yeah, those guys were on yesterday. What's up? Red Sands, what's up? I'm on Windows and I'm trying to make it faster. But so far I haven't found anything to optimize. It's like already looking good. View guidance. That's probably not gonna help. Show hotlines. What's a hotlines? Profile load sprite sheet. QLab, what's up? Vector bounce checking is only with the dot at. Okay. It's part of the STL standard. Oh, okay. It's part of the standard. Well, okay, I'm still gonna keep streaming here on Windows and see what I can do to maybe make it faster or better, or at least, maybe I'll spend the whole day today just in Windows to try and maybe even do some debugging or some bug fixing, so I can just get used to this a little bit more. I'm gonna keep on exploring modules. Looks like I spent a good deal of time here. Oh, wow. That's kind of cool. It actually shows me, yeah, this is usually the function render system animate that eats up most of the CPU on Mac too. Okay, modules, what do we got? Caller, callee tree. Functions similar to that modules one, a call tree, whatever that was. Lines, that would show the actual line in the code. You need a mic, yeah? Marks, auto mark, auto mark, auto mark. Auto mark? What's an auto mark? Could this be causing a slowdown? Does it automatically mark the code every once in a while, even in like release mode or something? Oh, it's a joke page. Download more RAM. Download more RAM. What is AutoMark? and profiling using Visual Studio. In order to analyze only specific parts of code, I'd mark the profile. Oh, so you have to actually type in some code or whatever, where I'd set a mark. The problem is that when I run the profile, it automatically puts many auto mark entries that could have the same ID that are reserved for my specific comments. And nobody knows the answer. God damn it. Yeah, I know it's tempting to say screw the chat, but the chat can be one of the most important things. It is. I would say the chat is one of the most important things because you're people and I'm people. And well, at least for me, it's the most important thing because I'm here to connect. I'm not here to just, you know, I do my normal development the rest of the day. That's when I get my time to flow and be in the zone. But during these streams, I like to connect with you guys. So it's not really about flowing. Download more RAM. Instant, fast, free. Please select the amount of RAM you'd like to download. We cannot download too much RAM. Yeah, that's cool. What is AutoMark? How do I disable it? Do I need to disable it? Probably not. Same guy asking this question. Nobody knows the answer. It's impossible to turn off AutoMark or whatever it is, but who cares? Let's move on. Processes. Yeah. Function details. Oh, this is kind of crazy. Telemetry main invoke trigger null pointer. IPs. All right, let's try the GPU one. Debug. Start diagnostic tools without debugging. Let's do the GPU usage. Start collection automatically. That's a great little option. I'm going to keep that on. Automatic. Diagnostic session failed to start. The requested feature is not available on this platform. Should have used the wizard. The wizard would have told me. The wizard would have been like, hey, I know I don't even know how to build windows that are going to fit on your screen, but you can't use the GPU thing. So don't even try, man. Okay, let's try some memory leaks. Let's see what we got there. Okay, we're profiling memory now. You want video proof of the laggers? I do too. God damn. Yeah, you know, it could have been their own system, right? It was only one person that reported a slowdown, and they said it was periodic, which could have been their system. Like, something on their computer could have done that. I would like to fix this whole scrolling, though. When it scrolls from one screen to another, it's definitely not V-Sync. Look at this. It should be V-Sync. You know what? I guess I could play. Yeah, maybe I'll play the game for like a good 5 to 10 minutes and see if something does happen. That would be good. The guys will probably torrenting porn while encoding another porn will play Sawbreaker. It might have been doing that to his computer. He didn't even know. You know? Windows is like that for me. There's things that go on that I have no idea why it's doing that. I used to know. 10 years, 15 years ago, I used to only use Windows. Today, I've lost all my Windows knowledge. Actually, it comes back. It comes back, even though I don't want it. Ooh, wait. Hey, this is cool. This is the Boogie full... Oh, yeah. Or not Boogie, but Kirby. Let's put that there. Yeah, this save game is pretty cool. Oh, really? It's tearing, but you guys can't see it? Yo, the green snake enemy? It's like a little tentacle guy. Lovely tentacle. It's like Day of the Tentacle. So OBS settings are really low, I guess, so you guys can't see it, but it is tearing the screen when I go from one to another. That's... Whoa, look at this! I thought this was a bug, but it's actually not. I could walk in here. Yes, yeah, it is tearing. Yeah, it's V-syncing tearing problem. Ooh, I could buy acid. Small demon's tooth. Okay, I'm gonna quit now. Alt F4. F3, F4? Let's check out this memory report. There's not enough space on the disk! It just filled up 5 gigs worth of stuff. What? There's 4 gigs left! Windows! Diagnostic session failed to start. Well, fuck it. Memory, who cares? Let's try, okay, I'll try one more debug session. Let's see if we can do something else. No, let's try debug mode. Let's see if we can actually profile in debug mode. Is that possible? The traitor behind the waterfall? Okay, I'm in debug mode now. Let's see if we can profile CPU usage only. Wait, what's this? Show all tools? These are the not applicable tools. I wouldn't want those anyways. Okay, I'm going to try profiling in debug mode, because debug mode is super slow. Yeah, I got to make it 60 frames a second more. More than 60 frames a second. There's some kind of cap. You just can't break? Oh, okay, Asmir's cool. Alright, so what I'm used to in debug mode, when I actually go to create a game or load a game here, it should be like hella slow, like it'll take forever to do this right here. Yeah, it's just loading. I don't know what it's doing. The sound stopping? It might be open broadcasters having a fit. It's okay for you though? Okay, so maybe not. It's last time I streamed on Windows, Open Broadcaster had real problems because I used every one of the CPUs to compile and it stopped the game. Okay, so there it loaded. And see, if I go to another screen, it's gonna have another spike. If I go back this screen, it'll have another spike. Let's go downstairs, it'll do another spike. Every time I go to any new area, it's spiking. I'm thinking that has something to do with memory allocation and or vectors being added to, maps being added to. Performance Explorer. Right. What? This is not helpful. Songbringer.exe, all the way down. Turtles, all the way down. Anybody know that expression? Turtles all the way down? Anybody? Wait a minute. This is not the same thing as the wizard. Dude, the wizard was so much better. Boogie. You're such a genius. The wizard is what I wanted. I wanted the wizard the whole time. Hold on, this is let's go to, I want to set up a setting here. Songbringer, projects, Windows, either one of these. Saves.txt, where is it? Saves. There's no saves.txt. Where does it save? Well, you know. Damn. Oh, here it is. Assets. Maybe it's right here. Settings Mac, settings. Let's just do settings Windows. Oh, here it is. Now it has it. Okay, if I go to this thing, saves now. Has that been updated? Settings Mac. No? What is this setting? This is the wrong saves file. Oh, there it is. Settings Windows. Okay. Next time I run this. I want the window size to full. I want what's the thing? Skip menu. Skip menu. Oh, I already got that. Skip menu one. What else do I want? Oh, it's because I was in debug. It do oh, so I don't get any good data? Damn. Oh, I realized why it didn't allow me to do on the debugging last time. Okay, so that's all I wanted. Skip menu. Okay, let's try this one more time. Let's try debug, start diagnostics without debugging. Run the wizard. Your guitar arrived. Nice, dude. Nice job on your website, man. CPU sampling. This little single pixel I can click on right there is exactly what I wanted. Was it? I guess it wasn't what I wanted. What did it Oh, maybe that wasn't the button. Well, at least I'm having fun with it this time instead of being frustrated, because damn, Windows sometimes can frustrate me. But so can lots of things. Okay, what do we got? Oh, it's not that one. That one's canceled. We want this blue one. Hide my taskbar? Oh, yeah. How do I do that? Just right click on it. Currently profiling. Yeah, go ahead. Just go ahead and profile, man. Oh, it's probably because it's loading the whole map. It skipped the menu, and this is where it slows the hell down a lot. Okay, yeah. So there. Whoops. Run away! Hey, check this out. It actually loaded this next screen kind of fast. What? Why? How? Songbringer PV stop working! I just pressed the 3 key, which would have turned on God mode, and it did this. Debug the program. If it's locked, you have to right click and unlock it, otherwise you just drag it down. Oh. It's not doing it for me here. But I unlocked it. Maybe it'll do it after this. Okay, let's break and see what happened. All right. Where's my callback trace? Right click property segment top. Oh. Auto hide the taskbar. Apply. Okay, great. So I guess the wizard thinks that I had that on all the time. Lime Studios, what's up, man? No, I've definitely not been converted. I'm just trying to do a little debugging and profiling today on Windows so that I want the game to run really well on Windows as well as Mac. And so that requires testing, requires playing, requires time. You know, I need to spend some time here on Windows. So I thought I'd do it with you guys because a lot of you guys use Windows. So, you know, hopefully that's a good thing. So I get crashed here. Let's see why. Oh, here we go. Here's the stack trace, right? Nope. Not the stack trace. Maybe it's this one. Main thread. Nope. Stack frame. Here we go. Oh, it was a SN printf. What's up, baby? All right, we found the stack frame. Yay! My baby Visual Studio. So what happened? Kit string the format on key pressed. Really? Hey, you know what? This might be a really good thing. God mode, percent S, enabled, disabled. No, that's fine. Nims, debug alert. Okay, I see what's going on. It's called string with format. It should have been fine though. These are both fine C strings. Passed in with the percent S. There's no extra arguments here for it to. I don't want the diagnostic tools. Why does it keep putting these up here? Here, let's throw autos. Let's throw autos and output together. And I want diagnostic tools and autos and everything here too. And then back to autos. Okay. Oh, it's the bottom right is the call stack? Did I miss it? Oh, call stack. All right, yeah. Oh, cool. So we got a stack frame up here. We also got a call stack here. Thanks, man. Okay, this looks fine. This whole statement here, I've seen nothing wrong with that. Is there some crazy opposite world where it would have crashed here? Let's see what's actually crashing. Buffer size. The whole point of this is for VSN printf is to maximize, you know, say how what the maximum number of characters are. So that should have been fine too. Does anybody have an idea why this is crashing here? Here's the line of code. It's calling basically kit string with format calls VSN printf. Here's the line, right? But everything it passed here into VA list args is fine. Let's try running it again. I'll try running it again. Dude, I hate this Performance Explorer. I don't want you. Here, throw this down here too. Go away, Performance Explorer. Whoa. Yeah, it might have just been because I was trying to profile at the same time. Let's play the game. Oh, hey, check it out. Here we got some spikes. This is what I want to look at anyways. Zyger, what's up? Here's the biggest spike right there. What happened right here? What happened? Functions, doing the most individual work. See, iterator base, get, cont, orphan me. I'm telling you, it's iterators or vectors or something. X closes things? Thanks, man. So if I got this open and I exit, it closes it. See, I was trying to pin it or unpin it. So do I want that auto hide on? I don't know. Oh, I can just click out. Okay, that works. Well, let's throw properties in with that too. Yeah, now things are getting a little more organized. I wish I could throw this up there, but I probably can't. All right, so why is that spike there? What's this? Oh, great, here it is, summary. But no, I don't want summary, I want call tree, songbringer. Application did finish launching, took a while. Wonder why that. Game scene, create scene. Ah, create world. Yep, create world. Create. Ooh, we might be finding it. We might be finding it. Steam key, give me a Steam key. Right? It's funny seeing me adjust, right? It's hard. This is so hard. It's so unfamiliar. It's like it's like trying to fly a plane or something for the first time. Yeah, Pedro. When you have those blue boxes, I think you can click in them. Oh, that other thing, the that other diagnostic thing. I think this is working though. Create Maisie. Let's look at. I want to find out exactly where it's slowing the hell down when it's creating everything. Add water. Is open path. Get area. Aha! Get area. This could be so much faster. Oh yeah. Okay, so what exactly about get area is it? It's probably in its world area. Yep, standard tree. It's looking things up in a map. This is a map lookup. Sweet, we found the cause of the slowdown in on Windows. Awesome, so I can work on that. I can optimize that here today in Windows. That would be cool. Don't save that. Let's run it again. Let's see if we can make it crash again when I do that God mode. You think your cat just farted? Farts. Okay, so this time I'm going to run it normal, local Windows debugger. So this is where it's the super slow down. I think I got an idea how to fix this. It could be way faster because right now it does three lookups. There's a Z, Y, and X lookup. I could just throw every. I could put make a V3I function that turns a ZXY into a unique 32 or 64-bit number, and then have a single lookup instead of three lookups per time it does that because it calls world area all the time. I guess if I go God mode, oh, it does not like the God mode. Break. Dude, what the hell? This looks like perfectly fine code to me. I don't get it. Why is this crashing? Or is it not actually crashing? Is this just breaking for some? Oh, I wish I knew why you are breaking here. There's some kind of, well, how do I tell why it braked again? You're preferring perversion 0.1, nice man. Okay, let's try something. Let's just try an alternate way of doing this. How about if I go string stir equals that, and then debug alert stir. Could I do a unique? Oh, yeah. Still breaks, doesn't like it. Exception thrown. Access violation reading location. I'm not. Why? Why? Break. Yeah, so it's before, it's as it's calling this. Does anyone have a clue? Enable's true. This, is this okay? Yeah, this looks okay. Right, man. Good night, man. Yeah, sorry it's so late. I was upgrading Rapid Game all morning and stuff. Okay, let's take it one more basic level down. Let's go auto C string equals that C string. So that should not, that should definitely not be null. Is it a C++ problem or a Cocos? It's a C++ problem for sure. Error reading characters of string? Maybe. I don't know why it would have any problem reading that simple C string though. Could it have to do with the buffer allocation in VSNprintf? Perhaps. But it is a static bu it's a static buffer that works. You know what? Maybe it does. Maybe I just haven't actually ever tried it. No. I know it's been used a million times before in this. Hey, there, it worked. Oh my god. So by taking out the freaking C string. Oh my god, really? And so if I turn on invincibility, it should probably crash again because it's doing the same thing. Oh my god, really? Why, Windows? Why? Visual Studio? So check this out. Here's what the solution was. God knows why. If somebody can explain this, please. Please. See what I did to fix it was to this is all I did. I basically just got the C string first. And then pass it into the string of format. If I pass this in right there as a you know what it is? It's like it let go of this variable before string of format could even use it. The problem is Windows. Well, yeah. Yes and no, but it's just really what it is. The problem is it's the way Windows handles certain things, you know, like this. I think it was letting go of this before it ever allowed stream of format to run it. Right? Let me do this. Const char star. I want to be really explicit there and not use auto, but make that a const char star. So I don't need to keep, well. I'll set a breakpoint right there. Breakpoint. Insert breakpoint. We'll run to there. And I want to inspect that C string. Why would Visual Studio or the way C it compiles in C++, it should be baking the C strings into the executable code stat or code page, right? It should never let go of those. It should never deallocate these constant C strings. Right, you're worried about the ternary operator part, but that shouldn't matter. Oh, you know what? Maybe if I put it in parentheses, that would be so weird. Maybe it's tripping on the condition. Maybe it is. I'm gonna try putting it in parentheses. Okay, so the C string. Yeah, see, look, fine. It's totally fine. Enabled. And now you go one more step. Not continue. How do I go? Oh, here it is. Step over, and string is now God mode enabled. Okay. Let's do that one more time. This time I'm gonna do. Let's take this breakpoint off. Breakpoint, delete breakpoint. Okay, so if I just throw all that in here, put it inside parentheses, you know, maybe this will work. Oh my God, this might actually be it. Yeah. No, string, good, yeah, stayed off. Very good question there. No, string of format is a function, but it is a dot 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 function of a variadic function. Show string with format func a sec. Okay, yeah, I will. Let me, yeah. Once this runs, I'll definitely show that. But yeah, it's just a variadic dot dot dot. So no, it does break even with the parentheses. So yeah, that's kind of proving that it's not a macro. Okay, so here's string with format. There's two versions of it, right? This is the version that's being called. It calls the dot 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 version. The dot 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 version just gets a VA list arg, starts it with format, of course, and then it calls auto ret is a C string, which points to this, the static char buffer. And then it calls string format with the args. Yeah, I know that was a really good solution. So how is it defined? Let me show you how it's defined. So here's the two definitions, right? Same thing. One is a dot dot dot. One is a VA list args. So there, it's just, and this is all in namespace kit. These are just, you know, namespaced regular functions. They're not members of a class or anything. So yeah, it's just variadic, the dot dot dot. Whoops. Yeah, and then so when it actually goes to create it here, it has a constant integer as the size of the buffer. This is a static array, so it has a single buffer. So one problem with this method is you can never call it twice within the same line of code, basically, you would need to store. I'm always safe about that. I store the result of this when possible. Why not add a breakpoint in here? I guess so. Yeah, let's try that. But oh yeah, let's do it from outside the one that's breaking though. Yeah, that's a great idea actually. Maybe there's some kind of insight there. Oh, I guess it would be nice to see a breakpoint of it running there versus running here, this mode versus that. Like, what are the differences? So a great idea. Okay, so breakpoint here. Thank you guys, you're helping me get more confident with Windows and Visual Studio. It's little things like this that make me wonder, you know, how can I understand Windows a little bit better and like fix bugs like this so that they just never happen again and I don't make these same kind of mistakes twice? Like, what the hell is going on here that's even causing this break, this exception? Three. Okay, we got the breakpoint. We're going to step into. Oh, it went straight into this method without even calling this one. I did not expect that. Yeah, F11, F10. I'm probably just not going to get in the habit of using those because I don't use it that often. So, that surprised me. So args is I don't know how these things are represented in memory, but it looks like we've got, it's just one argument enabled. The first letter's E, of course. So format 0 equals 0. That should just, you know, that should be fine. It's got a static char buffer. And maybe that should be defaulted to 0. Flips table. Alright. Oh, look at that. Okay, so the buffer already had something in it. See, this is proving that this is working for a lot of other situations in the game, right? It uses this all the time. The last thing it formatted was a string called fly5.ping. Here's our format. Args. Wait. I think it should have called this one. Wait, maybe not. Maybe it did call this. But no. Why didn't it call this one? Yeah, maybe that's the problem. Cast the args to a const char star? Yeah, okay. Here. Yeah, it is cast to a char star. Okay, let's add in a little bit of love there. Should I use static cast for that? Or reinterpret cast? Which is exposed? Yeah. Buffer size was red, really? I missed that. Okay, it's still in the breaky mode. I want to see it do both of these though. So I'm gonna set the breakpoint here and I'm gonna watch both calls to this method. Before the method call? Oh, really? Oh, cannot convert argument 4. Oh, it's a VA list, of course. Okay. Let's see if that helps. Const char star. Maybe that could be the whole bug right there. This is a possibility. Let's see what happens. So curious. This feels good. I feel on the track to learning something important. This is freaking basic. This is basic stuff that I did not know Windows needed. I love you, Windows. You got it. I got you. I'm gonna nurture you. Yeah. That's right. Massage your shoulders. That's right, Windows. You got it. Okay, yeah, Seaster. All right, I'm gonna step into this call and see. Yeah, look at this. It didn't call the VR. It skips this method here. Because this, oh, I think I know what's going on. I think the Car Star version, deep tissue. I think the Car Star version called this immediately. See, because we're not getting this method call. I'm gonna step out of here, step in here. Ah, see? It steps straight into this. I know. Variadic templates, right? I should be using variadic templates here, huh? Maybe I'll do that right now. The dot dot one only works if all args are const char star? Really? All right, Lime, see you, man. Can you explain that? Why does it only call the dot 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 one if all of the arguments are const char star? I'm thinking I should hide this method and only expose that method. Actually, I'm gonna do that right now. Oh yeah, okay. I think it matches VA list otherwise. Huh. Okay, maybe this will work if I force it to use this or I don't even expose that other one. Let's get this compiling. And here, this one is like underscore. I can do static here. I'm going to call this underscore version. Do not overload variadic functions. So you read that on some post. That's probably my problem, huh? This whole overloaded variadic function thing. It's Visual Studio had thought, oh, I could call this one or I could call that one. Hopefully this will fix the problem then. Hopefully it compiles right, nothing else is broken, and then this works. This would be a huge fix. Who knows what this could have caused crashes in the future, man. Seriously, this could have caused so many crashes all over the place. I just wouldn't even have known. People would be emailing me like, yo, the game crashed. I'd be like, no, how? Why? Why? I hope OBS is okay. Yeah, OBS looks okay while I'm compiling. Because I'm only compiling with two cores, so it should leave some cores or for OBS. Man, well, here's a lesson learned. If this works, then that's a big lesson learned. Don't ever overload a variadic function. Yeah, it's compiling kind of slow because it's only two cores instead of four. Man, I hope this fixed it. This is something I love about a Visual Studio. I love this whole Sublime Texty thing on the side. I'm glad I found that little option. Kit CPP is mine. Yeah, that's a custom thing. It's just like a bunch of different functions I would use in game development. Just little things like this, like string with format. You know, it's something that Cocos either didn't have when I started using it, or yeah, it's just basically something that the game engine didn't have. Clamp I, clamp F. These are, I think Cocos finally has clamp F, but that's an example of a function that, clamp, it's like such a basic little math function. I actually, C++ should come with its own clamp mode. Maybe it does. Does C++ have its own clamp? Yeah, and that's also something I can easily fix. You know, the benefit is I can fix it easily. The drawback is that this, like I come up with bugs like this. But I guess it's not as much of a drawback because I learned from it. Oh, that compiled. Okay, so I should still have that breakpoint. Let's check this out. Please work right this time. Why did I ever overload that in the first place? It's like I would never ever call it with the VA list args. Okay, I'm gonna step into this one. This one should be fine. Well, of course. Yeah, so it's doing the dot 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 version. I'll step out of that one. All right, next time. Here's the moment of truth. Oh, it worked. Lesson learned, everybody. Thank you. Vile Tom T, I don't know how to say your name. Please help me. And Azenris, and everybody else that understands way more than I do about Visual Studio. This is a lesson learned. Let me recap this. If anybody's watching the stream and you're wondering what the hell this was, this bug, this basically I had defined two different versions of this function right here, string with format. I had a dot 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 version. I had a VA list args version. For some goddamn reason, calling this with a regular C string, which somehow got casted to a char star, which didn't matter though when I changed it to const char star. Somehow, by passing that in, it called the VA list args version instead of the dot 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 version. But I think Azenris had it here. It's that overloading variadic functions might have and probably will have unwanted side effects. Yeah, make sure to remove the cast again. Let's definitely do that. Make sure that works. Okay, so input CPP. Now I can go back and do this how I had it at the first bit. Yeah, I'll remove all this old debugging madness. Wow, this is a really, I'm really glad I loaded Windows today. And I'm streaming on Windows. Because this is huge. There. That's how I had it before, right? It should be passing in a regular old const char star or whatever. It shouldn't matter to this because it now should call the right version of this function no matter what. I'm even going to turn off my breakpoint, run it again, and this time I should be able to click God mode and it'll be fine. God, this could have been so many crazy little bugs. Oh, stayed off, really? Oh my God. Oh, stayed off. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. That totally explains it. So, stayed off just commented here in Visual C++, VA list is a type def for char star. I never knew that. So it is written. So that explains it. Yes. And invincibility as well. Oh, totally. All right, guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, so next thing, I'm gonna work on making it load areas faster. So if I go from one area to another, yeah, BC Warrior for sure. That's like, I feel like enlightened right now. Thanks for that explanation. Stayed off. Yeah, I hope we all learned something there. Because, yeah. Yeah, so going from room to room is kind of slow, but especially starting the whole game is slow. So, basically, when I ran that profiling, it was showing that most of the time it spent when it loaded areas was in world area, and it does three different lookups for world area. It has to call. See world. Here's how it defines the world. Basically, the world is full of areas, and areas is this crazy complex map of three deep of Z, Y, X. You pass in all three of those, and it gives you back an area, right? So the slowdown is that it has to go look up in each one of these maps three times, and in debug mode on Windows, that's a slow thing. So it's probably doing some kind of bounds checking or some kind of something to make sure that memory's not being overwritten or whatever, or stepped beyond its bounds. And so I'm imagining if I make this to a single dimension map, like this would be a like an unsigned or a 64-bit integer, I can make these Z, Y, X stored into the all three of those. I think it'll work well. Yeah. Guess it's a good thing you were streaming when you got the error. Yeah. Dude, totally, Jackal. Totally. That's why I wanted to stream on Windows today. And, yeah. Faux placement. This one could also be better. So, world.cpp. So, yeah, when it looks up, the function that actually looks up is here called area. Here it is. You can pass in a const v3i, which is a vector 3 of integers. So, all I need is a method of a v3i. I should have kept kit open. A method of v3i that turns it into a single integer. Wheels, right? Watching successful debug is almost as fulfilling as doing it yourself. It's true, man. We all learn something, right? If you're paying attention there, you just learned something important. Never overload a variadic function. A C style variadic function. Oh, wait, I need V3I. Is there a quick open? I wish it had quick open. Does Visual Studio have quick open? Do you need to use map at all? Isn't the XYZ world courts? I guess I could. Oh, Azimris, you. Well, okay. The reason I was using. Oh, yeah. So I guess I could do it that way. The reason I was using a map is to make it safe. So if I did access a certain area, it could return a blank area. And in fact, I think I kind of want to keep it that way because, and it can go beyond a lot of bounds, right? I'm not sure exactly what Z level I would want access to, right? The game kind of creates its Z levels on the fly as it goes based on data. So I kind of want to keep it as a map. But yeah, good question there. That would be a real point where it could definitely improve the performance. Is there a quick open? I'm thinking of something where I would press a key and I could type in a couple letters of the file I'm looking for and it would just open it quickly. Like I think Sublime has that, right? I don't know how it works in Sublime. Quick switch, open project, no. Oh well. Okay, V3i, where the hell is that? I guess I gotta open it manually with the command line because I don't have it in my project view over here. So I've already got a hash function. Control plus. It's not working for me. Or is it command? Might be command plus for me. No, it's not doing anything. What's the Jacko Gamer? What's that you're pointing to help me? Like, if can I find that on the menu somewhere? Oh, Acer. Control comma. Oh, yeah, here. Oh, sweet. It was control comma for me for some reason. Let me try that. Control comma V3i. Dope. Look at that. Oh. Thank you, guys. Yes, it totally worked. Here we go. But it opened it here in the right. What's this right thing? Keep open? Oh, okay, so when it opens something on the right, I have to click the keep open to put it over here. Control comma. Is there a way to rebind your keys too? Would love to rebind my key so I would make that. I would make that like how I do it on Mac. Oh, I could check this out in a second, I guess. V3i CPP. Let's try this. The header V3i. This looks like a header. Yeah. No. No. Oh yeah, here it is. V3i dot H. Cool. Okay, so what would be the difference between this and its hash? X plus 1, Y shifted up 8, Z shifted up 16. Need advice on how you should build your overworld map, like how to handle trees, large rocks, etc. How you should build? What you mean? What part of how to build? Map is O log. Own order map is O1. Or worst case O size. Oh, unordered map? Let's try it. It's worth trying before I even do any of this stuff. But wait, unordered map, is that just as fast as, well, yeah, you're right, it's lookup. You're talking about lookup, right? Unless you need the order. Do I need order for this? Hell no. No, all I need to do is look up. Oh, shit. Unordered. Let's do that for faux placements. That doesn't need to be unordered, or that doesn't need to be ordered. Wait, wait. Let me just do this one at a time. One at a time. I want to break everything at once. So yeah, let's do a proper experiment here. Let's just make that unordered map and see. Oh, unordered map for all these. See if that fixes it. Be faster to load and all that. Okay, build away. Build solution. Okay, so if you have an array map XY that holds the ground tiles, okay, how would I go about adding the extras to the map? Oh, well, here's an idea. Maybe three layers. Maybe like you do, you have every one of your maps has three different layers. Like you could have a bottom layer of ground tiles. You could have a middle layer of like trees, rocks, entities, that kind of stuff. And you could have a third layer even on top of it's like sky or whatever else could go above the middle. Would that work? I've always thought about doing that for this game, but so far in this game I've just made it so it just has one map. But I have run into limitations there where it's like the same thing you're wondering there, like how do I just make that distinct? For now, I mean, I've just made it so certain entities, when I put a certain tile there, have things kind of just automatically stacked on top of them when they're created. But it's not really. Yeah, that's kind of what you're thinking? Cool. It's basically you're kind of creating a 3D, three-dimensional tile map. It's almost like you have block map or something. Or I'm not sure what perspective your game is just yet, but yeah. So, okay, so anybody just joining the stream, I'm working on this game called Songbringer. It's coming out this year. And I'm working on the Windows version. There's an update coming out this Wednesday. There's an alpha update coming out. And so I'm working on the Windows version today to make sure that the Windows version is running, is performing as well as possible, because some people have complained about a periodic slowdown. But I haven't been able to find that. But I have found some other important things. One thing I found... Oh, it's top-down-ish? Cool. One important thing I learned today was that when you overload a variadic function... it can really be bad. So basically I had this function called string with format. It had two different versions of it. One was a dot dot dot. One was took a varg list. And believe it or not, passing in a C string called the varg list version. Because, well, it all makes sense because it stayed off and everybody else helping there. We realized that basically that varg on Windows is typedef to C string, car star, char star, whatever you call that. So that was a very important lesson learned. And also I learned how to do profiling today. So that's debug, start diagnostic tools without debugging. I wonder what the difference, oh, profiler, same thing. One succeeded, sweet. Let's see if this is any faster. Doesn't look like it's any faster. But I would like to see this profiled, so I'll profile this in a sec. What about if I go from area to area? Maybe it's faster. Nah, I'm still seeing about the same slowdown. Huh, I really thought that would have worked. Not that I would undo that. That's probably a good move anyways to make that enough. Whoops. Vector iterators incompatible. Should I tackle this one right now? Vector iterator is incompatible. What? I don't know how I got that bug. Yeah, I think I might ignore this for now, because I really wanted to check on that, try and improve that this loading performance. It's way I want it to be way faster. There's so much potential. This should load instantaneously on Mac. It loads instantaneously. So here in Windows, there's just something I'm doing that's not smart. You know, it's got to be how it's handling this map, or I'm not aware. It's in debug mode, so this is why it's so much slower. I think it was a little faster, actually. I think that can happen if you delete an entry from a container and try to use the iterator, even though they all become invalid. Oh. Well, it shouldn't be doing that, because whenever I delete an entry from one of those entity lists, I'm doing it after the update. So I schedule things for after the update. Oh, there! It's right when it called, right when the guy did his, right when he launched one of his lightning things. Oh, maybe it shouldn't be adding to the array though, but it could be spawning. Hold on, let me check the spawn real quick. What? Do I have to click X for all these? Dude. Whoa. What? And now they're gone? What happened? Oh. I'm lost again. Oh, okay. K behavior spawn. What's up, Zelda Ethan? Hey, you're welcome to share your song. I'm on the stream though. I'm live right now. I'm not gonna have time to listen to it right now, but I can check it out later. So here's where it would be possibly adding in a new entity. And here it goes, and it schedules after update. It waits till after the update to create. Actually, maybe it's not spawn, maybe it's launch. There's a launch behavior as well. Attack system start shot. Oh, maybe I was wrong. Because, wait, start shot, let's see. Oh, this does. I think this does create an entity right away. Where is it? Yeah, world create AI. Oh, thank you guys. Ethan Muse, still same guy, same link, right on, man. Can I show get all? Sure. But I know it's this, man. It's definitely this. Let me try and fix this real quick. Where was that? Attack system, behavior launch. Oh, AI system. Here it is. Okay, so we need to schedule this for after the update. Schedule after update. This is just would capture all these values we need. It's a void function. E.id. Just Serval Zero. These are all copied by reference. So pause e dot position dot pause. Dirt lifetime color. There. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Another bug fix, hopefully. Oops. Well, I didn't want to capture E. Oh, oops. E. Pause. So there. Now it's gonna perform this when it launches a projectile from an enemy. It's gonna perform that after the update loop. Right after the whole tick and everything. So it shouldn't crash anymore. Another huge fix. That would have been causing problems definitely in debug mode, but possibly even in release mode too. They're copied by value. Yeah. That's what I meant. Yeah, sorry, Asnerus. I had that I said that wrong but thought that right. I promise it was straight in my head. Okay, so get one of these guys to fire at me. Yeah! Oh, two bugs fixed today on Windows. Nice. Okay. Cool. Let's see what we can do about that slowdown now from loading. I think it's a little faster. Why? Good question, Asnerus. Why doesn't it crash on Mac? I don't know. But I think on Windows it's a little more strict. I think it's like being a little, especially in debug mode, it's being way more strict about how it checks bounds and affects entities and stuff. Or I mean, loops over entities and all that. Yeah, right, yeah. Yeah. No, good point. It's actually a very good point. On Mac, it can be a bad thing to basically debug your game on all the time on Mac, because sometimes you miss out on these simple little things. Sweet. That was a great fix. Oh, I'm so stoked about that. All right. Okay, so, all right, next thing is to make the speed a little bit better. Actually, let's do one more little profiling pass. Just want to see it load. Currently profiling. The invisible menu, which one? So there's the overall load. Let's see, one or two screen switches, Alt F4. Analyzing report. There we go. Hey, look at that. It's a lot less spiky that time. Okay, let me do call tree again. Oh man, I wish this window was set up right every time. Create scene. Yeah, create world create, same thing, create Z, create maze Z, generate tiles, pattern connector, add water, is open path. Get area. This is the function that's really eating up everything still. Get area. But it subcalls world has pause. Oh, the Visual Studio menus don't show? Yeah, it's OBS what I'm using. Really? The menus like this? It doesn't even show this? Really? Oh, I wish I could see that. Oh, wow. You guys can't even see that shit? Oh my god. Yeah, I definitely have menus for me, but you guys can't see that. That's weird. OBS. Maybe next time I'll try Game Studio or Game Show or whatever it is for Windows. I'm paying for a license for that. They must use the same as Photoshop. Yeah, it's right. That's so weird. That's so weird. I promise I'm actually selecting stuff. So, okay, yeah, the same problem is this hash lookup. But this time it's using an unordered map, which is probably a little faster. It's probably faster to be doing this, but still, what's faster? Three unordered map lookups or one ordered map, unordered map lookup? Yeah. Okay, so I don't need that. I'm confident that if I go and create a better hash function for V3Is, okay, I'm gonna make this have some. Oh, actually, let's get it compiling while we're doing this. Let's make the world areas totally different. This is gonna be an unordered map of just long to area. Areas, and this is hash v3i hash equals area. Okay, so I can get that compiling. And world.cpp as well. Is there a quick open counterpart? Nope. Oh, but let me. Oh, how do I do that again? How do I change my key bindings? Is that possible? Keyboard. What is that quick open called? Navigate to? Thanks to Law. Navigate to. It's quick open. I want that to be Command O instead of the regular open. Elemento. What? Maybe it's not, is it not bindable or whatever? Oh, it's a good point, Asmerus, right? I should have made that a distinct type. I don't see navigate to, but let's what if I remove that? Oh, you can type in the box? Oh. Really? Oh, let me start that over. Tools, options. You can select a definition and hit F12. I have to hit function. Yeah, I'm not able to press any. If I press anything up here, it's not doing any. Is this what I'm supposed to do it? So if I wait, select a definition and press F12. Doesn't do anything either. Fuck it. I can learn to press control, comma. Hold on, let's make this the map type or the hash type for V3I. Let's make a hash type. Edit navigate to? Oh! You can type in that box, but I can't? What's with this? I feel so segregated, man. So it's edit.navigate to. Oh yeah, come on, baby. Come on, baby. Yes! Remove. Assign. Okay. It works. Oh! Yeah, it's probably boot camp, totally. Oh, Control K, Control Open is the matching. That's pretty cool. So if I'm here, let's try that. Control K. No. What did that do? What's this orange mean? Control K turns on some kind of orange thing for me. I don't know what that means. Oh, I have to press Control K, Control O? Like in sequence, Control K, Control O. It did. Lazy Shark. You're right, man. It's a sequence of keys you press. I pressed Control K, Control O, and it worked. You can right click. Where's the right click for that? Like open counterpart. Huh. Oh, toggle header? Toggle header? Oh, this thing? No, that's not it. I don't know. So clumsy of Visual Studio. Toggle header, it's on the page. Where? Here? Like, oh. Toggle header code file. Oh, thanks, Azimuth. Yeah, okay. Nice. Toggle header code file. So, does it work for even here? Yeah, that's nice. Cool. It's more memorable than Control K, Control O. Okay, so I'm going to type def a new type for its hashes. I want it to be an uns. Yeah, unsigned int 64. And then world.h, I'm going to use that. All right, let's get that compiling. Ooh, while we're at it, I'm going to change my other commands. Build, it's probably project build or build. Build. Build solution, is that the one I want? Control shift B. Yeah, build solution. Cool. I want to rebind that. So remove that and bind that to just command B. Currently debug select element. Definitely don't want that. And then run. What's build and run? I don't know which. What is this? Local window debug. What command is that? Yeah, Control Shift B. I'm rebinding them to things that I'm used to from my Xcode stuff. F5 build and starts the debugger. Oh, it's start the debugger? That's what it is, huh? Heresy. I know, but F5. Yeah, so I'm on boot camp. So for me to actually press F5, I have to go function F5. It's bullshit. So I'm just gonna rebind the things that are a little more natural for me. So it's debug, start debug, right? Debug start. F5. Sorry guys, I'm doing this for real. This is gonna be command R for me. I'm definitely never gonna use refactor encapsulate field. Assign. All right. Wow, I'm starting to feel more comfortable now. Okay, so in world.cpp, I need to change up its area. Oh no, oh, it's just world. Sweet. It's against the EULA. I would believe that. I would actually believe that. I bet you Microsoft had something in there about that. There's thou shalt not. Okay, there's gonna be a lot of places where it does this, like. Oh, wait. Oh, this kind of sucks. This is gonna change how I do this type of stuff. So, right, so I could loop over a bunch of areas. Well, yeah, of course there's gonna be a lot of errors, but see, this kind of sucks because I had a way where I could look up by Z. I could go loop over the whole Z index, right? And then the whole. I guess this could be rewritten like this. For auto ref area in world.areas. If area to get, whoops, second. Oh yeah, it's area. This is a pair, world area pair. Of course, it's a pair. Yeah. So if pair dot second, that's an area. Dot get pause. Dot z equals z. I don't know, kind of convoluted, maybe, sort of. Which one's better? Not sure. Just gonna kind of leave both of them for now. That's how that would be rewritten. Here's the main slowdown right here. This is why this was so slow. Three, the triple lookup. So this would be rewritten like this. Auto it equals world dot areas dot find p dot hash. Was there a typo in the reset? Did I do something wrong there? Is it because it still like has red? Oh, why? Yeah, thanks, man. Thank you, Sadoff. Much appreciated. Oh, and yes, look, it did get rid of its red thing. Oh, I didn't know. That's awesome. Good job, Visual Studio. I didn't know you had that feature. Cool. All right, so if it equals world areas dot end return blank area. Otherwise, return it second. Wait. So that should really improve the speed there. Oops. Once again, I still have an error. I wish it would show me the error right here. Why does it still have an error? World areas find p to hash world areas end. $5, I'm switched over to Windows. Hey, at least I'm getting more comfortable. I actually feel way more comfortable developing on Windows now. Okay, I'm kind of curious. Why is that a bug right there? I want you to show me. Tell me, Visual Studio. This is not, nah. See, it wasn't an error. Okay, so I don't know why it was like a dog on a bone and it just kept on thinking that was an error, but it wasn't. Okay, so there's two different kinds of area functions. There's area and there's area guaranteed, which creates the area and validates it if need be. This is easy enough. This is going to be areas.p.hash. I still haven't written the hash function perfectly yet, but we'll get to that. Oh, my bad, you guys. I was looking over here at this little red box, and it was because of that, not this. Yep. User error. Feel like a dumbass. Same thing. Okay. What else? What else do I have to change over? Here's another one where it's looking for a Z. So nobody's taking Boogie up on the bet? Because seriously, that's a good bet. What are the odds? Yeah, so all we're looking for is a Z level and flag entrance. P dot go, I mean, pair dot second dot get pause dot Z equals Z and the flag. You got no money to bet? Oh, Azimir's, I know how that feels, man. God damn. I'm pretty close to having no money myself right now, but I'm scraping by. I'm doing all right. Hopefully this will, by the time this game's done, I won't have to worry about money ever again. Ever. You can use Clang now? Whoa. Yeah, once you get used to it, totally. And I mean, I should be used to it. I used it for a good 10 years back in the 90s and 2000s. Pair a second I get flags, K flag entrance. Yes. So we're returning pair.second.get pause. Yeah, definitely has gotten better for sure. I love this is my favorite part, is this whole thing. I wonder if I can make it a little bigger. There's probably an option to make that a little bit bigger. It's oh, really? There's a clangish. Apparently it has Swift too? Whoa. Yeah, what's up, Salad Dogs? Howdy, howdy, howdy. I'm on Windows today, doing a little Windows debugging. Windows familiarity. I guess it's really just getting familiar more with Windows. I should be more, competent with all this. Okay, so I'm gonna loop over. What are we looking for? We're just looking for center. I hate comments like this. This might be unnecessary. Why did I write that? Oh, really? You can get that with third-party plugins? Whoa, what's it called? Do you remember? When is Linux debug today? It's coming up. It will be beta. So yeah, Lazy Shark, I haven't got the beta version started really, but Cocoa City X has all, has all the code already there. I just have to kind of hook it all up and get it going. So yeah, I'm not sure how I'll do that or how I'll stream that or what. I might do it in a virtual box on Mac. I don't know. But yeah, there'll be Linux debug day. Right, Sea Lion? Good. Yeah, that sounds really smart. Getting used to one thing. Definitely. Sea Lion? Wait, what's Sea Lion? Tell me it's super awesome. Oh, it's JetBrains. Ah, JetBrains. Okay, so it's JetBrains' C IDE, basically, or C++. You can also pull down that little thing above the scroll thing to split the window if you need two parts of the file at the same time. That's cool. Let me just try that. Whoop. Oh, that's kind of cool. That was actually sweet. I can get rid of it too, right? Oh, yeah, that's super cool. That's like smooth as butter, too. Wow. PHP Storm? Oh, right, yeah. An example how not to comment. People definitely don't ever comment like that. Oh, the package manager, Alcatraz.io. Let me check that out too. Alcatraz.io. The package manager for Xcode. And what was it called again? Code map? Code map. Well, I'll try this out. The package manager for Xcode. Cool. Awesome. Oh, this is great. I wonder if it has the there's a fuzzy find too function I always wanted to have. Alcatraz.io. Let me save this link somewheres. Resharper. Oh, thanks. SC Xcode Minimap. Oh, right on. Awesome. This is something I've wanted forever. Yes. Oh, I'm gonna get this tonight. Oh, delete that. Da 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 da. Sea lion. Should definitely check this out too. Even if it costs money, might be worth it. I mean, having being comfortable with one ID would be like a dream come true. New vertical tab group, same kind of thing, huh? CMake projects only. Ah, okay. Yeah, fuzzy autocomplete, right, yeah. Nice. When Xcode gets updated, you usually have to reinstall Alcatraz. Ah, okay. All right, how long is the stream so far? I don't wanna, if I'm at like 2.5 hours, I might have to call it. I'm at 2 hours right now. Let me do like 10 more minutes, see if I can finish this little hash remap thing here. So we're looking for an unexplored map position based on a center position. It loops over all the areas that are matching the center Z. That's easy. Yeah, if you got widescreen. Oh, it's vertical split. Oh, right. Yeah. It's kind of ugly, but oh well. Just want to keep both of these for now. You just pop a tag and drag it. Pop a tab. This thing's cool. Position is pair.second.getPause. If p.z is not equal to center.z, then we're going to continue. If the game scene does not have that a map position, we're going to continue. What the hell did I mean by this comment? Just gonna delete it. It's not helpful. Pair.second to get flagged secret. Center.z is greater than 0. It could have been checked. Oh, I guess that could be. You've had the full upside down T formation? Whatever. Right? Worst comment ever. Okay, this looks horrible, but this should be working now. This is not that critical of a function either. Okay, so now this one's looking for an entrance position from Z Grabbing it twosie. This is pear. That's pear. And we need to make sure this is from Z. All right. Two bigger monitors. Ah, right. Very good thought there. Get boss paws. This one's also just looking for a Z. This one's pretty easy. Looking for the flag for a boss, just returning a position of the boss. Get doors. This returns all doors. Okay, this is every single area. So this is a great example of something that we don't need any of these. So if this all works well, I'm just gonna delete all these crazy commented out things. Cause this is so ugly. Pair world areas. Just gotta look up auto ref areas now. Pair.second. Cool, and the last one should be this one right here where we're setting doors. Word, words, area, world, area, pause. Where's the error? Oh, it must be the unlocked doors. And auto ref, yeah, these two. This is also looking for a Z. Oh, stayed off. I just thought of something that could really make this easier. I could just do a lambda function. That's something that takes a lambda function that basically acts on every one of the areas. So I would do, it would be a function called like world for all areas. And it just takes a lambda function, which the lambda function takes an argument of the area. And so then I wouldn't even have to type in pair.second for any of this. And if I wanted to go refactor to use a different type of map or whatever, I would have to refactor only one method for the loop, basically over all the areas. And then I would just need to make sure that every area was checking, or every one of these calls was checking its Z or whatever it needs to check. So that would be awesome. Oh, look, we're done with the errors. Build. The one thing This might need to be improved, but this is 8 bits per. Should be okay. What was our error list? Error list. Oh. Yeah, I might need to make that better and make put some assertions in here. Oh, here's another one. Oh, I forgot that one. This one's super easy. What's up, Kofez? How you doing, man? Just doing some Windows debugging and familiarity training today. Yes. Okay. So the whole point of all this is to make it faster to load. I think pretty sure that was the bottleneck there. So let's see. If this loads way faster, yeah, I don't know. I don't think that did it either. I think that unordered map might have been all the performance gains we're gonna get out of that. Might be some other debug stuff that's doing that's just performance killing. Well, shit. I mean, that's not a bad move to keep the whole world that way anyways. All right. Well, let's run it one more time in debug mode. There's definitely been some bugs fixed today, I'll tell you that. It's been a very profitable, important day. Important day of learning and familiarity here with Windows. Let's go release mode one more time. And let me hook up my Xbox controller. Yeah, how does it perform with the release build? A lot better. Yeah, a lot better. But there's one issue in it ha where it has this VSync issue, like a t screen tearing when it switches areas. I'm not sure why. Or what's going on? You would still personally use vectors and access them through functions if you want a blank return and out of bounds. Yeah, would that really affect the performance, you think? If I'm gonna do it that way with the function for check for bounds checking, I might as well just make it. Might as well just make it a, you know, a regular old C array. That would be a little faster, right? Well, so I'm getting close to close to finish with the stream. I'm really just running it one more time here in release mode. I'll play around for a little bit for a couple minutes and just see how well it performs. See if there's any kind of periodic slowdown. But yeah, after I do that, this last play, I'm basically this is gonna be it for today's stream. So cheers, you guys. Thanks so much for your help today and everything. Check the GPU, maybe force VSync. DarkStack, thank you. Wait, oh, I couldn't do a GPU. That's not your. Are you talking about profiling? So how do I do that, DarkStack? How do I force it to VSync? in the Visual Studio Debugger. Is that like a debug option or something? Then you could iterate over the Z areas. Oh, they will be in memory contiguously, yeah. Yeah. When you're in debug. Right? I want to see how to do that. Oh, I might be my driver. Somebody else is talking about drivers here. Oh, I haven't bound my keys yet for my controller. Wow, it runs a lot faster, I think, in release mode now. That just could be wishful thinking. You're learning Kogo CDX? Cool. You're having troubles, like your sprites are very big compared to your Box 2D bodies. Oh man, that could be a lot of things. Have you checked if your sprites have any kind of scale applied to them? Also, you need to check your design resolution and all that. A, B, X, Y. Alright, so now I should have bindings. Yeah. Now I'm gonna bind the little buttons. Yeah, nice. Yeah, check your design resolution and all that. That could really be it. Alright. Did you guys see that? I guess I am streaming right now, so that might have something to do with it, but I am seeing a little bit of a delay every once in a while. I'm not sure if you guys can see that, because I think your frame rate's lower, but there definitely is like this periodic slight slowdown. There, it definitely happened right there again. God, I wish I knew what that was or how to fix it. But wait a minute, I'm not sure if it's doing the V-Sync problem either anymore. Yeah, it's definitely tearing a little bit still. It's not too bad. But, and I know you guys can't see it on the stream because the frame rate's so low and all that. Sorry about the quality. But, it is tearing a slight bit. I wonder if it tears for other people or not. I guess it could be my OpenGL drivers. I saw my key. Oh, I can open another door. Yes, Salad Dong's good. Good point. Very good point about that. Yeah, Box2D is independent of Kogo2DX, so remember that, Kofez. Remember that the Box2D is totally independent. Yeah, true, Lazy Shark. VSync could be a symptom, not the cause. Gotta remember that, too. Oh, bombs! I already opened that door, wow. Oh, Oh, you're not scaling the art, though. Oh, okay. Root Raspberry Pi. Git porting. I'm on it. It's Linux, right? Cocoa Studio X already has Linux support, so... Yeah, I feel like the performance is better today since that whole There's a recent thread on Cocoa Studio X, similar problem with Win32, no answer. Oh, no answer. Thanks, Sadoff. I'll look on the discuss and see if somebody. Maybe I'll go bump that thread. All right, Darksack. Thanks, man. Make Foo OS. Oh. Kind of want to. Cocoa Studio X stuttering. Thanks, Darkstack. Your camera? Maybe. If it was your camera, it would probably scale the Box2D debug sprites as well. Oh, I realize why I can get all these keys and all these doors are already open, because I've already beat this boss. Yeah, so this dungeon's already done. Alright, well, it was a good stream. That's it for today's stream. Man, learned a lot about Windows today. So I'll upload this video to YouTube, get some dinner and stuff, and yeah, thanks a lot, you guys. Seriously, you really helped me get comfortable with Visual Studio today, helped me realize a lot, helped me think about what could possibly be causing this stutter, and so I really appreciate you guys' help. It's really helped me a lot, so have a great night. We'll check you all later.